heading out to the Fred C. Babcock Wildlife Management Area today.
It's in Punta, Gorda, Florida. We've never been there before. It's about, would you say, an hour and 45, 2 hours from...
Yeah, it's about 2 hours from our house. We're going to go trail riding.
See what it's all about.
Try to see some wildlife, and we'll show you some video along the way.
You guys enjoy.
Figured we would go down this green trail right here and then cut across the yellow trail and then wrap all the way back around and then hit the red trail and see what that is like. So at this point in the trip, we noticed there was actually a lot of cows on the property, so that's one more thing you can look out for while you're there. Thank you. So earlier in the video, we had talked about a red trail that was on this property, and this was the trail we were talking about. It gets really soupy, and this was at a dry point in the season, so I can only imagine what it's going to be like when it rains. So in the video on this part, it doesn't do it justice of how sandy it actually is. This is some thick sugar sand, and I would definitely not stop in this. So on this next clip, you'll hear some gunshots. There's actually a firing range on the property, which I thought was pretty cool.
Download the maps for your area or wherever you plan on traveling to, just because like it'll show you where you're at, and if it's off lot of green trails out there. I'll post up on the screen the map of the area. There's one red trail that's out there where I would recommend either having some friends or, you know, just having a pretty good rig.
Is that the one that we were gonna go down? But
yeah, we went down part of it and then it got a little too nasty. I'm four-wheel drive, I'm, you know, 33s, but I would still go out there by myself. If I had a friend, I'd probably go down that trail, but other than that, I wouldn't. Unless you have like a huge rig that's on like at least 35s.
I'd say probably when it's rainy season, it's probably a lot wet, like a lot more wet than it is now.
Right now we went out there, it's pretty dry.
It's more like sugar sand right now.
It's really dusty. There is mud on that trail, but you really don't have to worry about it being too bad right now. But as soon as it's rainy season, I would definitely recommend a pretty bad rig, you know, to conquer that trail. Or some friends that are willing to pull you out or have a winch. I don't have a winch. I'm on a leveling kit, so we just didn't want to risk it. But other than that, it was pretty good. I enjoyed riding around out there. Like I said, it'd be a good, you know, day trip with some friends.
We probably spent, what, 3 hours, 3.5 hours out
I would
there.
Say 5 hours, and you could basically cover the whole park. Area.
It's definitely not as big as Ocala, but
Ocala is definitely like multiple days. We just went out there. We didn't record sadly. We've seen some bears and stuff like that, but like I said, it's not a huge place to ride, but it's definitely fun to go out there and ride around and just explore the trails. I'm sure after, you know, a handful of times, it might get a little bland just because it's kind of, there's only one trail that's really like challenging. You know, everything other than that, it's pretty. You can take your car out there on the green trails, but there are potholes, so you might want to watch out for those. It's good for sightseeing, I would say. Not so much off-roading.
But like I said, it's a wildlife management area, so they try to keep it, you know, as managed as possible.
Yeah, it was a good time out there. We definitely plan on going back just to explore the rest. We didn't cover everything, but like I said, it's a good day trip if you'd like to go out there. Thank you guys for watching, and please like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.